The organizations that met with the health minister included UNICEF, World Food Programme, Red Cross, African Union, World Health Organization Africa, UN Migration, Medicine Sans Frontiers, MALDMAY, World Health Organization, and AFNET. And the meeting was held at the district headquarters in Mubende.
We need to save lives, and we need to move really fast to save the lives. And we shall only do that if we are able to pick all the contacts from the communities and get them to where they are supposed to be.
During the meeting, the organizations elaborated their plans in the fight against the deadly Ebola disease.
We are aiming to reach up to
24.
So by the end of tomorrow, or the day after tomorrow, we should have fully 24 beds.
The minister met other partners at the district council hall, and later she met councillors, chairpersons, and village health team coordinators, among others. The RDC, Rosemil Biabashaija, who welcomed the minister, gave updates on the situation, explaining to the minister how they are handling the patients. She also updated on the number of patients.
Because as we talk, we have a number of suspects, about 37 of them, but a good number is responding well. And they are recovering, they can even claim for some food. So I really want to thank the team, the health team that has been hands-on.
Some of the councillors from the district were still not convinced on the Ebola reports. They explained their side of the story.
The alternatives, the government is taking over handling a pandemic, as you know.
Members of Parliament from Mubende, including Museveni William Ndoli from Buwekula South, Pasco Mbabazi, and Haj Bashir Rega Sempa, cautioned residents against politicizing the disease. They urged residents to be vigilant.
Masks don't protect you against Ebola. They protect you against COVID. Ebola is a different ballgame. So we need more clarification so we can give information to the population.
The health minister, Jane Ruth Acheng, has also urged leaders to sensitize and educate residents on the spread of Ebola and how to put the standard operating procedures into action.
Our strength in any response, and I want to repeat this very clearly, Madam RDC and chairperson, our strength in any response, and I've said strength. Our strength in any response depends on the communities. It is not about money. It is not about wash. It is about the communities understanding what is happening.
The minister asked organizations at the forefront in the fight against Ebola to present budgets so that government can provide the necessary support.
When you are not transparent, and I don't know how much money you have spent, it is not usable for me. Because then I don't know how to plan and ask Parliament to always be on standby with a certain amount of money for management of epidemics. So we need to take note.
Dr. Bayo, the officer in charge of World Health Organization, has urged all organizations to work together in the fight against Ebola. The health minister emphasized that the organizations are working together with government, but the health ministry has the upper hand in the fight. Report by Musa Kabogoza for the news in Mubende.